He has just made a table with using fancy words. Category rock stars. That means he thinks these are very good. So how many minutes? 10 more minutes. Okay, excellent. I am in good shape. So he says that their loss from first week to second week is less than 40%, and he gives three names. He thinks these are good names. Pan Singh Tomar. Anybody seen Pan Singh Tomar? Is it a good movie? Okay. Vicky Donor and Kahani. These are the three movies which stand out. Okay. Then there is a whole bunch of movies where the fall was between 40% and 70%. He calls them survivors. Mare nahi. Houseful 2, Rowdy Rathod, Ishq Zade, Tere Naal, Ferrari, G.O.W. I don't know, what is G.O.W.? Hai kuch hai. God only knows. But W kidhar hai? God only weeps. I don't know. That is, oh my God. And the most rotten films, Jodi Breakers. And then other, he doesn't even want to give names. Hate story out there, I don't know, it's a hate story out there. Anyway, the fake fellows, Agnipath, he said third class movie, they all cheated us. So he says, his argument is, they know damn well that they have a rotten movie on hand. What do? Uska jo hero hai, Hrithik Roshan ko ghumane ka, Bombay, Delhi, yahan, falana, walana, dikkat. Promotion is the word. So they come on TV, they come everywhere, they tell you this film is so great, and many of us are idiots. So we go, right? We see the movie, we come back. See, up to that point, no objective review is available. Then we tell in our friend, arey kya yaar, hum gaye the 400 rupees diye faltu mein. So he doesn't go. Okay. So we are the reviewers. And we get caught up by the promotion. That is how we get cheated. And next week, then nobody gets cheated. So that's the story. Agnipath, agent, we know, ek mai or ek tu. What? What is this? Alright. So this is the summary of his finding. Now here is a graphic presentation. On the x-axis is percent change from week 1 to week 2, and on the y-axis is average, what, I forget now. And there are these two movies, three movies, Pan Singh Tomar, Kahani and Vicky Donor, they stand out as those yellow stars. His choice of colors is not very good, so it's not very discriminating. But the right upper corner, there are three movies. Those are, in this graph you can see, right upper corner is the good movies, left lower corner is the useless movies. In between movies you can skip. So the left down here, mute story, what? Mate story, agent Vinod, ek diwana tha, ghost, char din ki chandani, tez, blood money, these are all hopeless fellows. So the same thing is presented in a slightly different format. Now come reviewers. Okay. So what is the take home message for me? Don't go to movies until 2 weeks are over. Then see the drop in income, and where there is no drop, go. That's the message. Then you go and buy a DVD or something, and it's cheaper that way. Otherwise, when I go to the movie, one thing is the ticket is expensive. Second thing, even the popcorn is expensive.
But even tickets are variable day to day, right. Show wise and weekday wise.
Correct. So skip the office, go to movie third week. No?
Bat in the show, 9 o'clock.
Five people special show.
All right. So this is the way to beat this game, okay? So don't go to any of the first day, first show craze. That is where you are going to be cheated. Alright, so let us go to reviewers. See, the idea is, or at least idea was, that media are for our help. But that is a foolish idea. Media are for making money for their owners. That is the correct idea, okay? So that plays out in every field, including reviews of Hindi movies, or that is what Khurana is saying, and he wants to prove it using objective statistical criteria. First week, nobody listens to reviewers. We are all mesmerized by the Hrithik Roshan dance. What is the Sonakshi Sinha dance? Item number. Right. So first week, nobody listens to reviewers. But second week, at least, some of us listen to the reviewers or read the reviewers. All right. So this is Khurana's graphic, and therefore, you know, it has not come out very well. But you can see the box plots. These box plots are for each, one box plot is for one reviewer. See, that reviewer has probably reviewed 20, 30, 40 movies. And the scores given on the scale 0 to 5, he has produced a box plot. So you can see by looking at box plots something you can say. For example, the third from the last, look at that fellow, third from the last. This person is extremely liberal and very rarely movie gets a score less than 3. Must be a very soft-hearted person. Cannot say anything unpleasant about anybody. Right? So, this reviewer is not, yesterday we were talking about discriminating ability of a test. So, discriminating ability of a reviewer. If your reviewer cannot tell you this is good and this is bad, then that review is of no use. I can, ahead of reading his review, I can predict. So, he will give 3.5 or 4 as the score. For any movie, so what is the use of the reviewer? Look at the first reviewer, Rajan Masand or something. Is that a correct name? Masand. Rajiv Masand. So, firstly, his range is 0 to 3.5. Kanjus aadmi hai, kisi ko bhi 4, 5 deta nahi. Okay. But he has a broad range. So, at least in his book, some cinemas are 0. Some cinemas are 4. That is the reviewer you want. The next fellow, Taran, see, these are ranked by their importance in some way. Maybe they are in big dailies like Times of India. I don't know how they are rated. How do you decide which reviewer is more important? I don't know. But this is supposedly declining importance. So, number 2, what is the difference between number 1 and number 2? Well, number 2 seems to be liberal with his grades. His minimum grade is 2.5. If you read reviews in Times or Indian Express, they give stars. And many of the films get half star, one star, one and a half star, two stars. So I wipe out everything with two stars, you know, at least 2.5 to 3, then I think about seeing that movie. So this guy never gives anybody less than 2.5. So if I followed this fellow, I will have too many movies to watch. Okay, so that is how these fellows differ from one another. Now, he has selected the two most important reviewers and plotted their ratings for 35 movies. So, on x-axis are those 35 movies, on y-axis those are the… So, the brown fellow is Taran Adarsh and blue fellow is Rajiv Masand. And you see some glaring differences, and 4 din ki chandani, Rajiv Masand gave 0. And the other fellow was very lenient, he gave 3. So, I think Khurana is suggesting that some of these people are probably bought. Okay. And that is why they don't play the role that media are expected to play in educating us and helping us. If that is the case, then that is unfair journalism, or at least that's what I would think. If I am wrong, our journalist friend should say something.
It is biased journalism. You can say that there is already some talks about paid news.
Yes.
And there is hardly any difference these days with the editorial content and sponsored content.
Okay. See, because we buy newspapers, we access media for two things, news and views. But we want them to tell us these are views and these are news. And sometimes it is very difficult to tell which is which. All right. So, this is another presentation. So, he thinks that Rajiv Masand is a halfway decent reviewer and Taran, whatever, Adarsh is somewhat short of an Adarsh. He is not Adarsh. He has to struggle a bit before he will reach that title. And something more, aggressive promo, never mind, we can skip this. Summary. So, we have run through literature, technical part of movies, you know, length of the shot, type of the shot, and economics part of the movies, collection in 1 week and 2 weeks. These are all variables of interest. Statistical treatment is possible. So, even in art, statistics can play a limited role, but still some role. Okay, it can improve our understanding of what is going on. You know, you are welcome to form your own opinions, but this helps everybody. And very simple tools. We did not do any fancy statistics here. Just simple graphs, simple plots, simple charts, simple averages. But you need basic data. If you don't have data on weekly collections of movies, none of this is possible. If you don't have data on the reviewers' assessments of different movies, none of this is possible. Therefore, this is a message to statisticians. Applied statisticians. Be thankful to people who generate primary data and make it accessible to us. So in this workshop, we are trying to bridge the gap. The data generators are sitting here. The data analyzers are sitting here. And each one can thank the other, because the generator does not know how to analyze and the analyst does not know where to get the data. So if you two come together, my favorite expression is 1 + 1 is much more than 2. Okay. And therefore, it's a good idea to get acquainted with data source and promote the data source. So, deal with your friends among users of statistics very gently. Never tell them they don't know anything, even if that is the truth. Because they are ultimately the data source, and they are what makes statistics worthwhile. Without user, statistics without users is life without sex. Thank you. I'm sorry?
You have 5 minutes for discussion.
Yes, sir.
I remember to read one beautiful article in IJMS, International Journal for.
Sir, please sit and hello. Tell and, the name also,
his
sir.
His name so is Dr.
M. N. Deshpande.
Deshpande.
His problem was, he analyzed 50 Oscar awards. And before Oscar awards, every time nominations are declared. And then particular movie, he has got 5 nominations, some have got 6 nominations. So what is probability that it has got a maximum nomination will be declared as a best movie, then best director and so on, and he did statistical analysis and good table was presented. I read it, but I don't have a copy of it. But
all
it
right.
Is there in International Journal for Teaching Statistics in Engineering and Technology.
Was there any unexpected conclusion?
Huh?
Was there any unexpected
now,
man
so
biting
it,
dog?
No, they said that from this you can, some people have fancy to bait for something and so on. So if this movie has got this many nominations, you can have this much bait and something of that type.
So if better think that more nominations means higher probability of
But sometimes it fails.
Okay.
That is what he showed.
That's right.
The analysis of all these nominations versus selection and so on. It was a wonderful article.
Any other comment?
Yes, sir. We have a very bad experience of this. Our book on life testing and reliability estimation, and that was written about 30 years ago. Myself and Sinha wrote it, and there was no data available to us. We tried in Canada, but nobody wanted to
give you data.
We tried in India, nobody wanted to disclose anything about this. But particularly in Canada, we had experience with Eaton's and Sears and other big stores. Nobody would give. We told them that we would relabel them or transfer the data and other, but we wanted some true data. So anyway, then we just generated data on the computer, because it was difficult at that time to generate the data, and illustrated the methods. The book had about two editions, and it survived and, you know, died after a few years, because now the subject has changed. about how to estimate the reliability and estimation. But it was our experience was very bad because nobody would give us any data.
Okay, I will tell you a story which is exactly the opposite of it. This story starts in 1950s or maybe even earlier, when Professor C.R. Rao was sent to Cambridge, England, for doing a PhD under R. A. Fisher, and the topic was measurements of bones of human beings. So he had what we call multivariate data, and he worked on lots of multivariate methods, and he came out with his first book called Advanced Biometric Methods, or whatever, methods in biometric research. Yes, and this book was well received, and it had lots of his own data, meaning the data he had collected or his colleagues had collected and analyzed, and it was the kind of book that you wanted to write. And then he says in one place, or maybe in one speech, that he then moved, for some reason he moved to USA and was teaching there, and the first edition was finished, and Wiley advised him that he should write a fresh book. And many professors said, we don't want that data business, we want solid theory. So he produced the linear statistical inference and its applications, which is more or less completely devoid. So see, this is a very wonderful indication of how times were changing in statistics. Statistics came mainly from Britain, where tie up with real life data was absolutely considered essential. You were not talking sense if you are not talking about a real life problem. Gradually, as statistics crossed the Atlantic and went to USA, it split into two. There were places like Iowa State, which was home for Professor Kale, or North Carolina State, or some other places where the British tradition was hung to. And there were some other places like Berkeley, California, and some others where people started chasing this demon called optimum result, and then they were less and less concerned about data and more about mathematical niceties. So a time came when the optimum paradigm became the dominant paradigm in statistics in USA, so much so that C.R. Rao was persuaded by the publisher to write a book without data. Luckily for all of us, the British paradigm is dominant once again for various reasons. I think that is the healthy paradigm for development of statistics. That is the absolutely only paradigm in which statistics can serve the cause of social development. But anyway, so things happen in history one way or the other. Yes. So ambience has changed, a lot of people are willing to make data available, and one of the things that we found in teaching of statistics was that the data used by teachers in Indian universities was some old stale British data. And I have no problem about British data, data are data, but we don't understand those things. You know, the American economic data is about corn prices in Chicago. Firstly, we don't eat corn. We don't know where Chicago is. Most of my students don't bother to look at the world map. Or hog prices. This is even worse. Bhai sahab, Rehman sahab, aapko malum nahi hoga. Lekin in statistics, illustration of pork is every other page is full of because that is written by the Christian white folks in United States. Very inappropriate for many other places. And my colleague Madhav Kulkarni and I, we used to fret over this, that we must have data which will motivate our students. Okay, so we decided to do something on our own, and we beg, buy, borrow, steal. These are the four ways of doing good research. So we collected data sets and we put them together, and we added something which we knew as teachers is needed. Firstly, we included a brief description of the problem, and then included our suggestions about how analysis could be done and some questions. This is available now on website freely, and now I find occasionally people actually
this
using
CD
these.
Is given to each of the participants.
You have that CD in your kit.
Yeah. Okay.
Last and then we will close. Yes, make your comment and I will walk away.
Okay.
Mr. Rehman from Bangladesh. Yes.
Yes, thank you. I have one observation regarding the data again, and also I will combine this thing with my economics. Like the data you have shown that people are going to cinema in the first week, it declines in the second week and third week and so forth. My question is, do those people go to the cinema in the second week again who are going to in the first week? Number one. And if not, then probably we can assume that a certain number of people and certain class of people go to cinema, not everybody. If that is the case, and if nobody repeats seeing the cinema again and again, then we can say the big portion has gone in the first week, the smaller part in the second, and third and fourth. So I don't see what the cheating is. And another question is, if the people that are going to cinema in the first week are repeating in the second week and third week, so in economics, we should say that the test for the cinema, that is the marginal utility, is declining. So it is going down. So where is the cheating?
Okay, so I will eliminate the rhetoric. So forget about my usage of phrase cheating and all this. Let us look at these only as facts. Everybody is free to interpret them in any way. As far as repeat viewing is concerned, we don't have the data on the website. So we are presuming that this is all first viewing. So thank you very much, and I am taking more time than what is due to me. So,
Mr. Farid is back.
Farid, please. Introductions. This is going to be a joint presentation. Farid and
Thank you. Dr. Sucharita Gadre, she is MA PhD and presently working as assistant professor in Jnana Prabodhini's Institute of Psychology, Pune. She has developed psychological...